The Duchess of Cambridge reflected on her own struggles as a mother today when she met volunteers on a new helpline for parents. She may have lived a nanny Maria Ball and a housekeeper available to help with Prince George, 5, Princess Charlotte, 3, and 8-month-old Prince Louis, but Kate, 37, suggested there were times when even she felt a sense of isolation. It's so hard. You get a lot of support with the baby as a mother, particularly in the early days, but after the age of 1 it falls away, she said on a visit to the charity Family Action. After that there isn't a huge amount, lots of books to read. Everybody experiences the same struggle, she added. The Duchess was at the quarters of Family Action in Forest Hill, Southeast London to officially launch its new family line, a telephone, text and email service providing support to parents and carers struggling at home. Kate, who met families and young carers who have been helped by the charity as well as some of the 60 volunteers operating its new helpline, has previously admitted being a mother can be isolating. In a speech at the Royal College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists last year, she said, "Personally, becoming a mother has been such a rewarding and wonderful experience. However, at times it has also been a huge challenge, even for me who has support at home that most mothers do not," she said then. "For many mothers, myself included, this can, at times, lead to lack of confidence and feelings of ignorance." Kate sat in on a role-playing training session for Family Line volunteers and staff, listening to someone playing a mom feeling isolated and down with a 6-week-old baby. Sagari Sarkar, a volunteer and mother of 3 who played the distressed mum in the training session, was impressed by Kate's understanding and experience of the issues. "I think it makes her human. It makes her in touch. She is a parent, a very active parent, and I think that's what people like about her," she said. "The reason why she's a great supporter of our service is that she does recognize that families have the same pressures and struggles, and she's no exception. She may have slightly different circumstances to the rest of us, but, you know, being a parent is being a parent. We all have the same struggles and challenges." The helpline has been piloted for the past 12 months but is now running as a nationwide service. Kate also met young carers juggling school with looking after a parent or sibling and talked to them about their fear of being bullied at school if it became known they were carers. She marveled at their ability to balance their studies with caring. "You all do an amazing job. I don't know how you do it," she said. Kate made a political statement with her fashion choice today, opting for a bespoke pine green belted dress by luxury London brand Beulah, estimated to cost £550. Run by family friend Lady Natasha Rufus Isaacs, the daughter of the Marquess of Reading, and Lavinia Brennan, the ethical fashion label aims to support the victims of sex trafficking in India. Kate accessorized the look with olive suede clutch bag and court heels in the same shade. She added a touch of sparkle with a pair of £1,400 diamond earrings by Kiki McDonough. She chose to wear nude tights rather than the opaque style she has worn recently, and despite the chilly temperatures, the mother of 3 went without a coat. Family Action offers support and advice to anyone struggling with any aspect of family life, including parenting problems, family conflict, relationship difficulties, money problems, or health issues. She sat with 3 families watching a new short film the charity has created to mark its 150th anniversary and promote its new Family Monsters Project campaign, which aims to help highlight everyday pressures and reassure parents and others that they are not suffering alone. The film, which is being shown at cinemas across the country in January, is available to watch, download and share at www.familymonstersproject.com. It features monsters appearing as families are affected by those everyday emotional, financial and other problems. "It was heart-wrenching. I wanted to cry," Deidre Greenaway, 30, a mother of 2 from the Caribbean island of Montserrat, said after watching it. Deidre, who now lives in Islington, North London, and her aunt, Dawn Daly, 46, told Kate how Family Action had helped them as they struggled to look after Deidre's 2 children, a boy, 9, and girl, 7, who both have neurofibromatosis, a genetic disorder characterized by skin color changes. Kate visited the charity as part of her work on early intervention to help young children facing disadvantage at the earliest stages in their lives. The visit was hosted by David Holmes, CBE, the chief executive of Family Action, who is a member of Kate's steering group. Mr. Holmes said, "We are so grateful to the Duchess of Cambridge for visiting Family Action's services today, for her interest in our work and addressing family pressures, and for officially launching Family Line. The Duchess's support will encourage many more families to talk about their family monsters." We last saw the Duchess on Wednesday last week, where she paid a visit to the Royal Opera House in Covent Garden to tour its costume department. A day earlier, she cut a remarkably casual figure during a trip to a community garden in Islington, where she helped to make homemade pizzas in an outdoor kitchen. Later today, her husband, the Duke of Cambridge, will interview Sir David Attenborough at the Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland. On day one of his two-day visit, William will take part in a conversation with Sir David on stage, discussing the broadcaster's work over the decades and highlighting the importance of the natural world. The talk will also highlight the urgent challenges and opportunities facing the next generation of environmental leaders.